So I'm recording this class. Let's start our class. We are going to present you the syllabus of your paper, this particular paper. So this is your syllabus. So your course contains is like, first of all, basic structure of Indian knowledge system. Here you are going to study the Rig Veda, the Upanishads, and all the other important books. Modern science and Indian knowledge system. For area you have yoga and holistic health care. Yeah, when we hear the word yoga, all of a sudden this is Baba Ramdev comes up in our mind. Yes, but no, we are not going to study about him. We are just going to study the evolution of yoga and all. And in the last case we have case studies. So that's it. Today will be our introductory class basically. So, yes. What is the need of studying this Vedas and all, right? This question might come up to your mind, but see here we are just trying to understand how knowledge system evolved in India. What was the origin of the knowledge? Okay, we can trace them back to the Vedic period and all. This I'll come back to you in the later part. So basically we are just studying the evolution of knowledge and nothing else. This has nothing to do with the religion and all this perspective. So yes, first of all, when we are talking about the Indian knowledge system, the undeniably most important part of this whole Indian knowledge system thing are the Vedas. Vedas are basically books that contains knowledge, like knowledge about Hinduism, knowledge about traditional India. Traditional way, it dates far back to more than 3000, 4000 BC. So it is a very, I mean, like, it is a Veda is a book which was compiled later on, but the knowledge that it contains can be basically traced back to many centuries ago. See, the we know that Indian society or Indian civilization that we have here is not a very new civilization. Maybe you guys have heard the word Indus Valley civilization or not, right? So the Britishers who came to India, they were basically of the opinion that the Indus Valley civilization was the oldest civilization that existed in India. But recent claims by scientists and all, it proves that there existed one more civilization much earlier to Indus Valley civilization, that is Rig Vedic civilization. Or you can say, not Rig Vedic, it is Vedic civilization. So Vedas is a book which basically contains what the daily life, the beliefs, the customs, the traditions of people of the Vedic civilization. See, Rig Veda is not something like which has lost importance, its importance in today's world. All the Hindu traditions, all the Hindu customs, all the Hindu ceremonies, etc., whatever takes place in the modern India, but in today's world also. We can see the priest and all the pandits and all chanting these mantras. These mantras, they chant in Sanskrit and all. These mantras can be basically traced back to the Vedas. All these mantras are included in Rig Veda. There are basically four types of Vedas: Rig Veda, Samaveda, Yajur Veda, and Atharva Veda. Rig Veda being the most oldest one. We will discuss about this. In the coming slides. First of all, let me tell you that in the earlier, like times, older times, when this Vedic civilization was launched, all the mantras and all the chantings and all the knowledge, whatever it is, people, they never used to write it down anywhere. All the mantras and all this used to be memorized by the pandits, memorized by the learned people of those times. And it was passed on to the next generation, like father would pass on to the son would pass on to the grandson, this and that. For many centuries, this tradition was passed on from the older generation to the younger generation. Yes, so you can say that the Vedic civilization was Vedic knowledge was an oral knowledge system. And these Vedas used to be arranged in such a way, like poems and all, which made these people, made these people very easier to understand. So, and also recall. So, I think you guys have heard the surname Chaturvedi. Chaturvedi is an Indian surname. Basically, it is, used in North Indian side. So, Chaturvedi is the title which is given to a person who has mastered all the four Vedas, who have studied all the four Vedas. See, this class might be very boring, and see, it is 3 o'clock, 3:30 at this point of time. It might be very boring. So, I'm taking it slow. You also just relax and listen. So, yes, here we are in the Vedic section. So, let us see what are Vedas. The Vedas are considered the earliest literary record of Indo-Aryan civilization and the most sacred book of India. Yes, Vedas are the most sacred books of India. Yes, we know that. And all the, we can trace all our ceremonies, all the mantras and all. Yes? Is anyone saying anything? Okay, I'll continue then. So some Britishers who were practicing or who were doing the research work in India, they believed that there was a series of Aryan invasions from the Central Asia, you can say from Iran and all the Middle Eastern part, Central Asian part. There were a group of people who invaded India. This group of people were Aryans. And so, these people, they came in India and they wrote the Vedas and all. The Rig Vedic civilization was nothing but the writings of these Aryans who came from Central Asia. So, this was the belief which was popularized by the British learned people, scholars and all. But subsequently, in the recent years, the Aryan invasion theory has been rejected, and so the scholars and all believe that there was no such invasion as Aryan invasion, and the Vedic civilization, it all developed in India. No one invaded India. So Aryans were basically the people who were residing in India during that point of time, during the Vedic civilization. Okay. See, this part of history is always debated. There is no clear-cut evidence of its existence. So, it is debated. So, now the recent claim is that there was no Aryan invasion. In some near future, you may also get to know that there may be some evidence about Aryan invasion. So, we don't know. So whatever is presented to us, we will study that. And also the other important thing is that there was a huge debate whether Indus Valley civilization. I think you guys know about Indus Valley civilization. The Hrithik Roshan wala movie, Mohenjo Daro. Yes, it deals with Indus Valley civilization, Harappa, Mohenjo Daro, something like that. So there was a huge debate whether Indus Valley civilization was more existed prior to Rig Vedic civilization. See, what we know is that we have evidences of Indus Valley civilization. We know practically which are the sites, what used to be the lifestyle of the people of Indus Valley civilization and all. But there is no such evidence about Rig Vedic civilization. We don't know who these people were. what they did and all. Nothing. There is no such physical evidence. We only know what is written in the Vedas. So hence, from the knowledge that we get from the Vedas, we have a fair idea who the Vedic people were. And also, there is a point that the Rig Vedic people, they knew nothing about rice. Okay, the rice thing which we eat. Yeah? The Rig Vedic people did not know anything about rice. So in Vedas, we do not find any mention of rice and all. But we have ample evidence of rice being cultivated and consumed in the Indus Valley civilization, thus showing that Indus Valley civilization is new. I mean, like younger civilization than Rig Veda. Okay, that's it about the civilization. Okay, let's get back to Vedas. Vedas are the original scriptures of Hindu teachings containing spiritual knowledge encompassing all aspects of life. Yes, we all know Vedas, it consists of all the traditional knowledge, spiritual knowledge and all, everything. The word Veda means wisdom, knowledge or vision, and it serves to manifest the language of the gods in human speech. So, see, it has been said that nobody knows how, I mean, like, who wrote the Vedas and all, how the people of Vedic civilization, they came to know about these things, all the rituals and all, nobody knows. So, it has been popularly believed by the Hindus that Vedas were the language of God. God themselves came down to them and they told them, like, they told all the rituals and all the knowledge and all, everything was told by God to them, and hence they had compiled it up. That's it. And the laws of the Vedas have regulated the social, legal, domestic and religious customs of Hindus up to the present day. We have already discussed this. All the obligatory duties of Hindus at birth, marriage, death, etc. are guided by the Vedic rituals. Yes, the pandit comes up and he chants all the mantras in Sanskrit language which we do not understand. Those mantras can be traced back to Vedas, basically Rig Veda. The philosophical maxims of Vedic literature have stood the test of time, and the Vedas from the highest religious authority for all aspects of Hinduism and are a respected source of wisdom for mankind in general. So Vedas, it is not just Hindus who look up to Vedas as an ultimate source of knowledge, but also many Western philosophers, many Western thinkers, many Western scholars, they come up to India to study Vedas. Hence, it is that important. So let us study about the origin of the Vedas. It is difficult to say when the earliest portions of the Vedas came into existence, but it seems clear that they are among the very earliest written wisdom documents produced by humans. So Vedas are considered to be one of the earliest documents ever written. I mean, like, it was not written in Rig Vedic generation or civilization. It was compiled up later, but yes, it is basically very old. Okay. As the ancient Hindus seldom kept any historical record of their religious, literary and political realization, it is difficult to determine the period of Vedas with precision. Yes, we do not know at the actual period of the Vedic civilization or when Vedas were written, and hence it is highly debated. Historians provide us many guesses, but none are guaranteed to be precise. It is thought, though, that the earliest Vedas may date back to roughly 1700 BC. So Vedas were compiled at a very later stage. That's all it is saying. Who wrote the Vedas? Tradition has it that Guru did not compose the regular compositions of the Vedas, but that God sent the Vedic hymns to the sages, who then handed down to generations forward. Another tradition suggests that hymns were given to the sages, who were known as the seers or mantra drashta of the hymns. So basically, what I told you, it is saying that Vedas are believed to be the language of God. And God himself came up and revealed them to the sages. Sages means sadhus and all. The formal documentation of, okay, I'm repeating the same side of it. Okay. Classification of Vedas has something to this. There are four classification of Vedas: Rigveda, Veda, Sama Veda, Yajurveda, Veda, Atharva Veda. The four Vedas are collectively known as Chaturveda. So hence I told you about the title Chaturvedi, surname Chaturvedi. So the earlier three Vedas, the Rig Veda, Sama Veda and the Yajur Veda, are considered to be oldest form of Veda, and Atharva Veda is considered to be the recent addition. Atharva Veda is very different than the earlier three Vedas. Let us study what is Rig Veda. Rig Veda or the Book of Mantra. Rig Veda is a collection of inspired songs or hymns and is the main source of information on the Rig Vedic civilization. It is the oldest book in any Indo-European language and contains the earliest form of all Sanskrit mantras dating back to 1500 BC to 1000 BC. Some scholars date the Rig Veda as early as 12,000 to 4000 BC. So we know that Rig Veda is the oldest Veda. And there is a confusion about the timeline of the timeline when this Rig Veda was written down. So different scholars, they put down different timelines. The Rig Veda accounts and details the social, religious, political and economic background of the Rig Vedic civilization. Yes, from Rig Veda we all know, we have a very detailed knowledge about social, religious and political and economical background of Vedic people. Even though monotheism references some of the hints of Rig Veda, naturalistic polytheism and monotheism can be discerned in the religion of the hymns of Rig Veda. So we know that Hindus, they believe in 33 karma gods. Hindus believe that there are 33 karma gods in all. But Rig Veda has a basic tone of saying that there is only one God. Although in the later stages we can have an idea of being like many, God being in form of many avatars and all, but Rig Veda basically sets the tone for God being a single being, a single entity. Sama Veda. The next Veda is Samaveda or the Book of Songs. The Samaveda is purely a liturgical collection of melodies. Yes, all the mantras, all the chanting that are included in Rig Veda is presented in the form of song in the Samaveda. The hymns in the Samaveda used as musical notes were almost completely drawn from the Rig Veda and have no distinctive lessons on their own. So the Samaveda basically does not have any distinct lesson to teach on its own. It is basically a song or a musical version of the Rig Veda. And also that is why it is called a reduced version of Rig Veda. As Vedic scholar David Solomon puts it, if the Rig Veda is the God, is the word, Samaveda is the song, or the meaning, if Rig Veda is the Lord and Samaveda is the civilization, if Rig Veda is the wife, Samaveda is the husband. So basically, it is just saying that Samaveda is as important as Rig Veda. The third Veda that we have is Yajur Veda, the book of rituals. All the rituals that we perform at this current period or that is Hinduism can be traced back to Yajur Veda. The Yajur Veda is also a liturgical collection and has used to meet the demands of ceremonial religion. Ceremonial religion means all the ceremonies concerning ceremonies. The Yajur Veda served as a practical guidebook for the priest who executed sacrificing eggs while muttering simultaneously the cross prayers and sacrificial forms. So, in Yajur Veda, you will basically find how a particular ceremony has to be performed. How the rites, how the mantras and all they have to be spent. So Yajur Veda speaks all about that. Last but not the least, we have Atharva Veda. Okay, this is just a brief introduction. We will deal with this in the later classes in more detail. Too. So, last but not the least, most modern version of Veda is Atharva Veda, the book of spells. The last of the Vedas is completely different from the earlier Sri Veda. So, as I have already told you, Atharva Veda is very different from the earlier Sri Vedas. Maybe you have heard the name Shushruta. The first person from traditional India, I mean like ancient India, who performed cosmetic surgery and all that. This person, Shushruta, and all his knowledge of medicines and all, everything is written down in Atharva Veda. We can find information about this surgery, medicines and all in Atharva Veda. Also, Atharva Veda is called the book of spells, which means that all that is required to put on spell in the negative sense, you can say that the magical spells kind of thing. This thing can be found in Atharva Veda. So that's it. We are done with this introduction of Veda. Thank you. Okay, sorry, I did not see that this chat. Let me see. That's it. That's it. The Europeans, they were never considering that India could be a bedrock for a large civilization and all, or something like that. So that is why they were saying all this about Aryans and all. Aryans came and invaded this and that. And also, they consider Aryans to be the superior ones and all. Hitler used to consider himself as Aryan, as Aryan. So that's it about today's class. I'm going to put up video link in the ERP. You please go and give reading. Let's meet in next class. If you have any problem, you can ask me questions. Those who have given your attendance, you can leave the class. Thank you, everyone. If you have any questions, you can ask me. So I have enrollment number 3, 6, 10, 5, 17. Yes, that's it. If anyone has been left out of this, you can send me your enrollment number. Otherwise, you can leave the meeting.